Okay, so last week I teased you guys and I mentioned something about great white sharks. I was supposed to go on this fucking trip with a good buddy of mine, Dean Del Rey. I paid for the whole fucking trip. My part of the trip, I should say. And I was going to go in a shark cage while they chum the fucking water. And I was going to, with great white sharks swimming by me. I was all set to go. Everything was a go and all of this shit. And then this fucking business, you know, there was this edit and this fucking, I just couldn't get out of it. And I had to, I couldn't fucking go. And I was devastated, but I'm happy that I got done what needed to get done. And if you guys want to see what I missed out on, go to Dean Del Rey's. I'm sure he's already uploading pictures. He's getting back now. And, he's the reason why I went, because he went years ago. And dude, like, the pictures look like Discovery Channel shit, and I'm terrified of fucking sharks. But I want to see a great white shark at some point in my life, and to the universe in a safe fucking way. I don't want to be on a sinking ship and be like, oh, I finally got to see one, right? So I wasn't able to do it. So not only do I not get to do this, okay? And I end up having to edit all these fucking episodes and shit because even though the show isn't coming out until spring of next year, we're still in crunch time because that's how doing a show works. There's never enough time. There's never enough money. They can't fucking, it's just, and you're always behind. Somehow we just have to fucking get this done now or we're going to be fucked. We're going to be fucked. It's just that 24/7, right? So I'm glad that I did that, but, fucking blows. So anyway, so I'm back here. All right. And I'm driving around Los Angeles and at rush hour, I pull up to this fucking stoplight and it's like, there's two lanes of cars. All right. There's like two people in front of me. I stop and next to me, you know, there's three people and that's as far, you know, I don't even look in the rearview mirror and I'm just sitting there. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000. And then I hear what sounds like a fucking explosion. Just boom. And I went, whoa. And then I don't even remember somebody hit my car. Right. I don't even remember feeling that. All I know is I just saw this fucking Prius just driving right down the fucking middle of all of the stop cars. Just went right by me. Sorry about your ears right there. Just right. And just side view fucking mirrors, just flying off every car right down the side of my car. And he just comes to, or he or she comes to a stop. All the airbags deployed in this person's car on the side. I couldn't even see who was in it. So all I'm thinking is like, oh my God. Fucking obviously classic example of texting while driving. This motherfucker was looking down and at the last second was like, fuck, and just tried to shoot through the middle. So I hate when people get into little fender benders like that and then they just get out of their car and they leave the car where it's at. It's like, will you just drive the fucking thing over? Get it out of the fucking way so people behind you can get out of there. So what I did was I pulled, you know, there was like a street, you know, a couple feet up and I just pulled into that street and pulled over. And the person still hasn't gotten out of the car. Everybody else that this person hit is out of their cars now and we're waiting for this person to get out. And I'm thinking like, oh my God, like, are they unconscious? Did they hit their fucking head? I mean, that really sounded, the impact was unbelievable, right? I get out of my car and all I have is this on the side of my car. All the person got was the side view mirror, but it's bent all the way the fuck back. So like, basically you could pull up next to me and you could like brush your teeth in the mirror because it's pointed right at you if you were parallel to me. So finally, the fucking car door opens, and I actually felt bad for the person. I was like, oh my God, they're going to be so embarrassed. They're going to be fucking mortified or whatever. And it was the exact opposite. This dude gets out, and he just starts cursing everybody out. He got out of the car yelling at us. This fucking guy just hit five people. And he's like, you motherfucking fuck you. And he's going, fuck you, you fucking bitch. And people now, of course, people are videoing this person. All right. And he starts, you fucking bitch, you fucking, this is the person you should be, get video of her. You fucking fuck all you guys. And well, I'm like, this guy was like, he was so fucking committed to yelling at us for half a second. I started thinking like, yeah, what did I do wrong when I was just sitting there at the traffic light, not hitting anybody. So the funniest thing ever, right? These people start to engage this person in the argument. It's like, why would you waste your time arguing? This guy just hit five people with the car and he's yelling at us. He's literally knee deep in side view fucking mirrors. Like, do you really think that you're gonna say anything to this guy and he's gonna stop mid screaming and be like, oh yeah, okay, fair enough. Yeah, that's a good point. Didn't look at it that way. So I just start laughing. I mean, it was fucking hilarious. This guy just hit five fucking people, and now he's yelling at us. It was fucking hilarious, right? So he gets into his car, and he grabs like three backpacks, and he puts them on himself, and he goes, "Get used to it. This is what LA is going to be like." And everybody's like, "Whoa, hey, post 9/11, what the fuck does that mean?" He yells at the lady more, calls her a bitch another couple times. And I don't know if they were both fucking jockeying for a position or he felt she cut him off. But I think this guy just went total fucking road rage. He just picked a spot and he's like, I'm fucking getting there before you and I don't give a shit. This guy just fucking snaps. So he grabs his fucking backpacks and then just walks away. Walks down the street like fucking, I was joking with my buddies, like Andy Griffith when he's taking Opie to go fishing. He just fucking walked away. And I was like, this guy's out of his fucking mind. He hit us. He's yelling at us, and then he walks away. Like, I'm done with this shit. Like, one of the greatest displays of entitlement I've ever seen in my fucking life. I mean, what if there was a pregnant lady he hit? I mean, this guy hit this fucking first person so hard. I looked down. I thought it was a hubcap. It was this chunk of a rim. I said to the cop, I go, is that plastic? He goes, no, that's metal. That's the rim. It's like, Jesus Christ. So he, by the time the cops get there, that guy's just gone. He is gone. That ball is gone. So I call up a buddy of mine because now I'm like fucking pissed going like, Jesus, what with the arrogance of this guy. And then I'm thinking all that shit. I just, what if I went up and I just said, no, buddy, you shut the fuck up. And then I knocked him out. And then, you know, you go into your hero fucking thing. Yeah, what if I did that? Oh, wait, that's right. I'm a pussy, you know. Oh, wait, I don't like getting punched in the face. Oh, that's why. I don't have even a white belt in any martial art. That's why. That's why I sat there and did nothing. Oh, I forgot. That's right. That's why I did nothing, right? So I call up a buddy of mine who's a lawyer. I remember a long time ago, I got into it with this woman. And we went up to the stoplight. And she was like, you know, she beeped at me, so I beeped back at her. And she beeped at me, I beeped back at her. And then she just fucking hammered the horn all the way up to the light, like 400 yards. Stops and holds it down and is staring at me in the rearview mirror. What? And the second it stopped, she held her horn down for 30 seconds. And the second it stopped, I just went, beep. And me and the woman I was with fucking started dying laughing at her. And then she all of a sudden put her car in reverse, backed into me really lightly, and then got out, reached into her glove box. And I sat there like going, oh my God, is she getting a gun? What the fuck? And she wrote down my license plate number and then drove away. And I, of course, thought nothing of it. I was a young man. And next thing you know, I'm on the road and I get this. I'm checking my voicemail. It's like the 90s. This is how long ago this was. And it was just like, yeah, Mr. Burr, this is Officer So-and-so from the El Segundo Police Department investigating a possible assault with a deadly weapon. Or whatever the fuck it is, because basically your car is a deadly weapon. Now, isn't it battery if you actually hit somebody? I thought assault was either threatening somebody or making them feel like you're going to hit them or something like that. That's assault in a battery, assault, and battery's actually doing it. So anyways, because of that fucking thing, I knew that, you know, watching this guy leave, I'm like, okay, that's five counts of an assault of assault with a deadly weapon. We got video of you screaming at everybody, so you can't say you were texting or listening to the radio. You've basically admitted that what you did, you kind of did on purpose. We have you on video. Everyone knows what you look like. And then you left the scene of the accident. So I call up a buddy of mine who's a lawyer, and I just left the message. I was like, I just want to know what kind of jail time is this guy looking at? How long is he going to go to jail? My buddy calls me back, and he just goes, I go, yeah. I go, do you fucking believe it? He goes, yeah, man, that's crazy. And I go, how long is this guy going to go to jail for? What's that, like 3 years? And he goes, you know, if he's a first offender, I mean, the jails are crowded. You know, he doesn't have any other priors or anything like that. He just has like a rage issue. They probably just suspend his license indefinitely. They send him some anger management things. And I was just like, no jail time? And he was like, when he got out of the car, like, what was he saying? And just, I couldn't believe it. I was like, you can fucking hit people, five different people in a car. No concern for their well-being whatsoever. Get out, curse everybody out, leave, and not fucking go to jail. It's unbelievable. What the fuck do you have to do to go to jail? And he was just like, well, you're going to put him in jail, and nobody becomes a better person when they go to jail. He's going to be in there with a bunch of fucking maniacs. So I actually feel irresponsible to let people know out there that you can basically do what this guy just did, and you're not going to go to jail. I'm sure he's going to get arrested when they find him. I don't know. I was pretty blown away by that. So there you go. Instead of looking at sharks, I got rear-ended by this guy. But I got to admit, every time I think about that guy yelling, it was fucking hilarious. And I start thinking, like, was that just like a strategy for him to get the fuck out of there? And everybody goes, like, it was probably a stolen car. It's like, who the fuck steals a Prius? How do you start a Prius? How do you steal one? Can you hotwire the fucking thing? I don't know. I have no idea. So I love how everybody becomes like a fucking sleuth, you know? Well, yeah, probably what he... What was the circumstances? Oh, okay, let me listen to you with your complete lack of fucking... That's why I called a lawyer. I was like, I don't want to talk to other people. Because I mean, he'll probably get like 7 years, you know? I never even took a lawyer class. Lawyer class. I never went to law school. I'm a moron. All right. I'm also trying to type in my password, so I immediately become extra fucking stupid. Did I type it in right? Yes. Okay.